Well, hello again. My YouTube account has been granted permission to upload videos longer than 15 minutes. So I'm going to do a single sitting of the Tomb of VARN. So prepare yourselves. Now on with the quest. I am Mullion, Guardian of Enroth. Thank you for replacing my memory modules. Archibald took them from here when I refused to give him any help in his battle for succession. Your timing is impeccable. The Kriegan have invaded our world, and you must try to stop them. Unfortunately, Archibald's attempt at extracting information from me have damaged me enough that I cannot help you directly now. Instead, I can only give you advice. While most of the Kriegan can be slain with ordinary weapons and spells, the elite guards and upper echelon breeders have tougher skin and natural defenses that protect them from anything but very powerful weapons. In the planetary control center beneath me, on weapons and armor you will need to survive battle with the enemy. My orders, however, will only permit passage to someone with a control cube. My instructions tell me that the only control cube left in Enroth can be found somewhere underground in Dragonsand. So, we are off to the Tomb of VARN. And as some of you may know, it's not really the place you want to hang out at. First up, we are going to level up. Let's see. Gym is probably closed now. Wait a few hours and train. Recall the Castle Iron Fist. And train up 10 levels. In 10 minutes.
Hey, look, well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well
done. And I'll probably spend all of those on magic. 109 skill points. Well, for him, I don't have anything else but sword mastery to give him, so that's what I'll do. And for the Archmage, let's see. I could pick up Dark Mask before I go in there. Might be a good idea. So, put some points in Dark. And Light with her. And with him, I'll put some more in Fire, I think. I'll be using Fireball a few bits. Like that. So, off to get Dark Mastery, which is pretty easy to do. Should cure insanity, I think. I'll fail. Gonna cure that first. And Sorbigal.
Can we assist you?
Heal. Then we're gonna have fun with the townsfolk here. Cast Armageddon. And that instantly takes care of all the inhabitants which come falling from the sky. It's a funny sight. And that gives us a notorious reputation. And now we can become a Dark Master in Sweetwater, I believe? No. It's in Paradise Valley, so we should travel west from Blackshire. And I believe we can just donate a bit to the church in order to get our reputation back up so we don't have to go to prison. Wouldn't that be cool if that was true in real life? Let's see. Paradise Valley has Hydras and Titans in the overworld. Both pretty potent in killing us, so I'm just going to avoid those for now. I can easily dispatch of those if I feel the need to. Of course, I'm going to open these chests because they have a ton of gold. And it's pretty much free loot. I believe the town is just somewhere west of here. course another obelisk isn't bad to pick up either. I can see the first few pieces of town on my minimap already. And yeah, there's titans inside the town. Luckily, I think I know where the Dark Master is, so I won't have to go searching for him. I think it's in this house. Or not. Master of Dark, there we go. And he's pretty evil, judging from his sprite. And we just became a Dark Master. After having done that, we'll just retreat to Nisalbergul. Ignore the dead bodies.
I've repaired it.
Repair the gear that was broken. Just one. And head to the church. Temple to donate a bit. To get our reputation back up to at least respectable. There we go. And now we're off to Dragon Sands, I believe. Gonna just take the teleporter here. And you've already seen the Tomb of VARN. It's in the center. Somewhere in the center. And this is probably the longest dungeon in here. In the entire game, actually. Tomb of VARN. Enter. Before we enter, the real dungeon will buff up. And we should have pretty crazy resistances and stats right now. Yeah. 27 the recovery time. It's pretty fast for someone wielding a sword. Well, anyway, resistances are looking good too. I should be good. Okay, let's do this. From what I can remember from this place is it's incredibly big. And there's monsters that cast sleep spells and all sorts of annoying shit. So I'm just gonna set up a beacon here where I can retreat to when I teleport out for healing or whatever. I don't know if afraid reduces your accuracy. I think it might, but the stats are high enough to just ignore it. Set power cure to quick spell. And these genies sometimes drop wands and I believe magic lamps and rings, as I just saw. Increases rate of recovery. That's decent. She doesn't have one yet, I believe. I'm just gonna clear out the entire place anyway, so. Or at least the safe spot. That should be good. Can I read this? I can. You were able to decipher the message through the crossing of the void below, blah blah blah. Blah blah blah. Blah. Nothing I care about. So those were genies. One of the two types of monsters in here. A tree if you carry the if you count the droids later on. And those are the second few defenders of VARN and stronger versions of them. They tend to be quite painful, especially considering they shoot energy blasts, which are unresisted. Luckily my damage is pretty crazy, so maybe I'll be fine. Down here, the first real room, and there's quite a lot of them already in here, so I'm gonna rush in there and do something crazy. I'm just gonna slowly kill a few at a time. Sucks I can't use fireball in here because those F3 are immune. Lightning bolt and ice bolt seem to do fine. Thanks to my resistances. Yeah, you should come close. You'll get wrecked. My melee damage is so much higher than my range damage. This doesn't make any sense. In a game where magic is supposed to be, well, set to be the stronger of the two. Let's see how many there are in that corner. Sounds like a lot. Nothing a little melee won't fix. There we go. Oh, finding all sorts of stuff from these. Oh, forgot to turn in the jewel leg. Oh well. And we found a key. We should hang on to those because there's a lot of doors that require keys. And I found an artifact. That's cool. Let's see which one. Conan. An axe, so pretty useless to me. Still, quite a nice find. I didn't think I could find any of those here. There's one lost genie out there. I feel sorry for him. Just die, would you? Okay, and as you can see, this place is retardedly big. What I usually do is go to this corner or side of the room or whatever you want to call it and reach up there, because I believe you can with the jump. Or, well, I keep close. I should be able to make that. There we go. And these are the Sentinels and Guardians of VARN. Stronger variants. However, my melee damage is so good, I can kill them off pretty easily. And I think I skipped quite a big part already by doing this. But seeing as this is a dead end, it might just be intended. I don't know if it is intended. I'll probably never find out either. But I usually just do this. And then I should be ouch. I keep targeting my Archmage. I should be close to one of the genie, yeah. Genie slash Efreet slash Jin rooms. There's really a ton of them here. In each one of those alcoves there's a genie or Jin or whatever. And this is probably gonna hurt. Gonna kill off these first few in melee and then hopefully live in order to throw in a dragon's breath. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Maybe I should throw in a few fireballs too. I should have set up that beacon way before I did go this far. Because this might just hurt me a little more than I want it to hurt. Yeah, it does. Just to be safe, I'm going to town portal out and put up a beacon at the entrance. Because I do not want to die during this recording. I might as well just heal up now. Get back there. And as we're really close to the ending of the game, I probably won't have any need for gold anymore, so just gonna ignore the treasure and most of the corpses laying around. At least a new sorbical. And I'll set up a beacon downstairs. And due to fraps being about 4 gigabytes for every 5 minutes recording, I hope my hard disk has enough room in order to capture all of this so I don't run out of space. We'll find out after this. Set up the beacon here. Over the castle Darkmoor. Well, wire from that. This probably is leading somewhere too. Yeah, I could take you guys. Easy. This is probably a dead end for now, but never know. This is a dead end. Genies. And my observing eye spots a switch and a chest. With a key, flame door key. And another crystal skull. Remember this thing? We found one a long time ago in Ethric's tomb. And the captain's code. These are all references to the Star Trek universe. The captain's code is Crick. And if you change that around and spell it backwards, you get Captain Kirk. Now, who might that be? There's about 5 of those in here. 5, 6 maybe. Wow, you can't even get back up without a jump. That's not a door. I try to get back up here again. Oh, there's one up there. Did not see you. How did those get out here? Might as well just jump down like this. I've already seen to aggravate a ton of guardians and sentinels, which is good because now I can take out a few at a time instead of a group of 20 or 30 of them. And I have decided what my next Let's Play is going to be. I was thinking about Super Mario World, but I decided not to because it's probably been Let's Played far too much already. So I decided I would do one of my other childhood favorites, which is Secret of Evermore. It's pretty unknown, I think. It's sort of like Secret of Mana, with a few changes, most notably the alchemy system. And I decided it would be about that game because it's not been let's played as much as Super Mario World, but it's still a SNES game, and those are pretty easy to let's play, so I'll probably have some others doing it as well, but I just like the game that much that I can enjoy it. And because of the time limit removal, I'll have a far easier time splitting it up in bite-sized chunks instead of what I did with this game, is just record for a number of episodes and upload them without intros or whatever. Now, luckily, I was able to take out quite a few of those foreign guys. Probably still a lot of them though. And that one's immune to electric, of course. They don't have that much HP actually. Dragons have far more. There we go. You guys out. I expected this to be harder, I guess. That's probably because I'm well prepared and I invested the skill points in the skills I actually need instead of wasting them on earth and mind magic, for example. And it looks like I'll probably manage to complete this without dying. We got him. Yeah, knock on wood, I know. I seem to target one of my characters constantly instead of the entire group. But oh well. I will probably be fine. And in here, the library, which should contain a bunch of spell books and I believe a chest as well, with the something code. I don't know which one. And this should leave my inventory with quite a few spell books, which I can or cannot learn. Most of them I probably already know. Meteor shower. Yeah, everybody knows Meteor Shower. Fly already knows it. Mass Distortion is useless anyway. Town Portal, Lloyd's Beacon, Starburst. Okay. Ice Blast. Incinerate. Yeah, most of them are already known. And then in here we should avoid them. There's a chest on this side. With... oh, it's locked. Okay. Guess we need a key for that one. And that's probably gonna contain a code, because it's locked. And then you'll probably have to find a key on the far other side of the dungeon. And get back here to open it. Typical. So... let's see. That's gonna take me to one more of these rooms. Hopefully, not all of these alcoves have a few genies, but I think they do. You're pretty easy to kill in melee anyway, so it's not a huge problem. Unless they start floating around in a big room. Because in that case, like this, you'll get annoying. They don't deal a lot of damage anymore because of the resistance spells, but it's still annoying. And I'm not gonna skip them because I know we have to come back here a few times. Yeah. Got him. Kill you too. I don't think it's one of the genies that's gonna drop a key. I'm gonna suppose it's inside another chest, but I'll never know for sure, so I should probably loot them. I take it the red ones are the strongest ones because they seem to take the most hits. Yeah, I'm talking about you. With a beard. Of course they all have beards, but still. Looks like another one of those rooms up ahead. Exact same room probably, but seeing if this one was pretty easily taken care of, I should be okay. Keep finding rings and stuff, which are probably pretty good, or at least valuable, but at this point, who cares? Let's see, I have one crystal skull, two crystal skulls, that makes you immune for radiation, which should activate in the next little bit. Not yet, after this room I think. Wow, I missed it. And them falling asleep is quite annoying. Should probably just melee. Looks like it's faster. And less annoying to be honest. Probably gonna cast a shared life because her life is quite low. And these things are so annoying. Luckily though, this is probably the biggest hassle in the entire dungeon anyway, so once I'm done with this part, it's mostly just looking for treasure chests and keys instead of running around killing monsters. Now I can see those sentinels up ahead. Hopefully I won't aggravate them yet. This room's almost done. Probably just gonna put up a beacon here and recall after I healed at the temple. Because my priest's mana is getting quite low. Oh, looks like I pulled one. And two more. I can take care of those. It's not too much. Let's see where we're at. Oh, some more. Should be able to take these out too. Let's see. Fire Blast does work. Then Toxic Cloud too? It does. It's not the damage I hoped for, but it's better than melee attacking, I guess. I might just make a challenge run for myself someday. Set the beacon over the... let's see. Don't think I'll ever return to Elo Festival Horse. So. I do make myself a challenge run and do this game without an elemental school caster. Which would mean no teleporting, no flying, no Lloyd's Beacon. I'd like to see how that works out. Because even getting back here would take a long time. Let's see, haste, four more arrows. Man. It's high quality items here, but I don't need any more of those. Why does this lead? Suppose I should wake him up. This takes us to... oh, that's the back door. Then I suppose the back door key is used. It is. That takes us to an even bigger room. How awesome is that? And I can see some djinns over there. Quite a lot of them, actually. So, I suppose I should take those out. And hopefully not die in the process. Let's see if they're immune to Dragon's Breath. They're not. The damage is hopefully manageable, but it looks like there's quite a lot of them. I don't have any incredibly powerful arrow effect spells besides Dragon Breath. Might just make it, I don't know. Oh, Dragon Breath costs so much mana. Don't think I'll have enough of that. Okay, Priest took a beating there. It doesn't even look like there's a treasure chest out here anyway, so... let's run. Put jump on quick spell here. Let's see. Nope, there's no treasure chest. I do see passage up here. Which would probably mean a code? Water temple door locked. So, that means I have to find some other way to get a key. We found a flame door key. I don't know where that's supposed to go. We haven't explored this part of the dungeon yet. Or this part. It's so big, I mean, how the hell am I supposed to know where everything is? Last time I completed this dungeon, I took like 3 to 4 days of trial and error, so. Yeah. Not surprised, it's a maze. Mulling is probably better than spells because of the recovery time. Quite sure of it actually. Let's see, where are we now? Another incredibly big room. Whoops. Tried to do a jump here instead of shooting a fireball. That's an invisible wall. So where does this go? Entrance to the central pyramid lies to the south. Okay. See what I can do there. Not breaking gear.
It's fixed. It's fixed.
I think we're gonna end up in a pretty big room with like 100 monsters. Because the central pyramid is that big. Okay. Can always recall. Okay, that's a long elevator. Takes us up to, I don't know, hieroglyph switch thingies. Warning, cargo lists are strictly off limits to another personnel. Use the sign of the scarab is restricted to supply offices only. The mild electric shock will be transmitted to violators. Okay. And this is an exit. Okay, so that's pretty useless. That just takes us down again. Okay, so that's useless. And that guy's freaking out. It's just an elevator, dude. Calm down. So that's a useless passage. Backtracking is fun. Do see a few aggressive monsters, though. Take those out. Suppose I could ask the way, but since they're mostly aggressive, doesn't do a whole lot for me. Keep targeting her. Anything up there? There is a door. Or what appears to be a door. No, it's a hieroglyph something. Picture door. It's a door. Takes me up to, I don't know where it takes me. I doubt this leads anywhere anyway. There's a single VARN guy here. Sir, do you know the way? Maybe he has a key. He doesn't. Well, weird placement for him then. All alone. And not a single djinn Suppose I should take him out. Nothing from him as well. This feels a bit useless. Let's see. We still have a path to go out here. So I suppose I should do that. Recall to the beacon. Go the other way. And wake our priest. Sleepyhead. Yeah, another intersection, which is good. Gives me more ways to go. Unless they all lead to the same place, of course. Just some gins. I could take those. The spell effects are so big, characters sometimes can't attack because they can't see him. If you can't see anything, you launch your ranged attack, so. Evil designers. Cloak. Another useless plate armor. Cloak might be fun too. Nope. And this room. Sentinels. And another way around. That was useless. So where does this take us? Okay, there were a lot of VARN guys there. That might just be the main room. Well, you need to input those captain and stuff scrolls. Yeah, they're coming for me. Just want to take you out. Probably do that account around the corner instead of being in a line of sight. I don't care. Come on. Come on. I'll annihilate all of you in melee. Okay. Seem to be doing pretty good. Put up a new beacon here. Probably teleport out again to heal. Just to be on the safe side. And if it's night, not yet. Can still heal here. The entire Overland population of New Sorbical is probably dead now. Because of one Armageddon. I am the bringer of doom. Well, this one. Because the way this dungeon is designed, there's a lot of walls on top of each other, which makes looking at a map even harder. Crap, they're weakened. Haste ran out. Call of power. Hour of power doesn't even work when you're weak. Makes my recovery time incredibly big all of a sudden, probably. Cure those weaknesses. And this is the downside about haste. If you have a high enough spell, you should be able to keep track of time, but since I failed terribly, I lost track of time and they got weak. Should be good now. Recast our power. We got haste this time. So, where does this lead? A bit down. I'm just gonna jump across. And we have a huge spirally room. Okay, gonna skip that for now. Take this spirally thing up. If it even goes anywhere. Oh, it does. Let's see. Can I even go up further? I can't. Only thing here are a few sentinels, but oh well. Yeah, I think I can just jump down here too. Yeah. Okay. And then I guess I'll go this way. Or not. Dead end. I guess I could go right there, but then I'd skip the spirally thing room. And the jump down here probably takes you down there, so might as well just jump down. Or not. What have I got myself into? Oh crap.
We got him.
Yeah. Okay, so that doesn't lead. Oh, there's a hallway. Did it come from here, or did I? Whoops. Did I skip that? On the way down, because I know there's some places here you can only reach by jumping. Well, it came from here. Good. Then I will go the only way I can go, which is out here. Kill some more of you dogs. Or Anubis guys, if you want me called like gods. Anubis is the god of life, I suppose. Not into all the Greek and other. Okay, just take me to the spirally thing. And one more way. Gonna go the other way first. Because I know the spirally thing this takes me back. What will we find out here? Change of scenery all of a sudden. Oh, come on, not a maze. It is a maze, with all the walls still on top of each other, which makes the map reading incredibly annoying. What's this? Nothing, just a nice picture. And I could have just rushed this dungeon, just like Castle Darkmoor, but because this place isn't as annoying, I figured I might as well just run it like I should. And because I haven't really shown you any dungeons that are a pain in the ass yet, I think you guys deserve one. Okay, that just takes you back. I'm not gonna jump down there yet, because there's another passage here, which takes you to the exact same spot. Okay. This looks like a place where they could hide a chest at. I did not notice my Archmage's health that low. Yeah, there's a chest. Making progress here. Yeah. Water Temple Key. And a Relic Maze. Sure, why not? What does it do? 30 fire damage and 24 fire resistance. Don't relics always have a downside? Oh well. Do have place for it. And the first mate's code, which should be Spock. Yep, Xops. Backwards, of course. So now we have two codes, the captain's code and the first mate's code. And that relic I should equip. Yeah, 10 times better. It doesn't have any negative effects. That's odd, because all relics have a negative effect, except that one, apparently. Okay. Then this should lead us somewhere back up. What's this? I can't jump that either. That's probably the end of the dungeon. I can hear the humming again, so that's probably where the control cube is at. Make my way back up again. Get back to that water temple thing. Hopefully in the water temple thing, we'll find a key for the library chest. Okay. Lots of blue, just a few purple and red. I can manage. They don't seem to be that aggressive anymore. They just ignore me. Didn't take even 1 point of damage in that fight. Oh well, can't complain, I guess. I'll probably take a bit of damage from this fight. Well, it's not as many of them as I expected to be here. Now, my priest is hitting for quite a nice amount of damage too because of the fire. Extra fire damage on that mace. Which makes her a bit more potent as well. But still, maces are incredibly slow, so. That's cool for an archer. Maces are incredibly slow, so she won't be as scary, I guess. And hello, Mr. My Head is Stuck in the Floor Man. Crazy genies. Okay. Now to find a quick way back to the water temple thing, which was here. Guess I'll just take a left. I have a beacon up here, I think. Which, in that case, I should have casted before running back up here. That was pretty useless then. Does this take me outside? Maybe? Just a dead end? Yeah, just a dead end. I like slaying dogs, so just take you out too. Not dogs, you dogs. I don't like slaying dogs. I like slaying weird dark things with staves and dark faces. So that's a dead end. So the only place we can go now is that one incredibly huge room with tons of mobs or water temple. This is not the way I want to go. Head to the water temple. And I'm doing surprisingly well, in my opinion. I expected this let's play to be around 150 parts, but as I'm recording, probably an hour or 1.5 hour of footage from this dungeon. I don't think I'll make 100 parts, which isn't too bad because I've seen RPGenie's let's play, and he took 365 parts. So, yeah, I think I'm doing quite good. Can't complain. Now I should be able to open this door. Yeah, I can. Okay. The only two dungeons left after this one are the control center and the hive, which is the final dungeon. And we have another chest. Yippee. Let's see. Golden Blade, not care about those. Navigator's Code, which should be Sulu. Ulus, yes. And another Crystal Skull, that makes three. Do I have a place for it? I'll make place. Money and Bibliotheca chest key. For the library, I assume. Make room for you two. And a vampiric precision bow. Okay. I don't know, does that mod then also work on melee attacks? If so, I'll take it. Because that's an incredibly useful mod. It's fixed. Yeah, I'll give it. It's fixed. Yeah, I'll give it to my priest because he's the only one really meleeing often besides the dagger guys. She needs the healing instead of them. Because she has to stay alive. It seems to be working. Wow. Okay, back to the library. Well, I accidentally overwrote that one. Guess I'll just walk. I'm looking forward to Secret of Mana, Secret of Evermore. I haven't played that game in ages, and, well, my original concept of starting a Let's Play was about a Super Nintendo game. Instead, I made it about this one. Chest with the VARN chest key. And the doctor's code, which should be McCoy? Yep. Sorry, I just like Star Trek. Take the key along. I don't know where the VARN chest is. I sure as hell hope it's not in the center. Oh, look. Figured there was something hidden here. Books. No, they're not books, you idiot. Those are the first mate code and communication officer's code. Okay, looks like we have all of those, which means we only have to go to that center room, take out the entire huge group of monsters in that room. Yeah, I think I'm gonna just run in there and pull a lot of them and run back here and then kill them all with hopefully a few well-placed dragon breaths, because there's so many of them. There's no way I can just kill them all in melee. Oh crap, there is a lot of them. As you might see, you sometimes take radiation damage because of the radiation here, and having the crystal skulls helps absorb the damage. And stepping in one of these pools cleanses your radiation. Okay, so that didn't work out the way I planned it, so I'll just stick to melee. The town portal will not kill you first. Town portal back to the new circle just to heal. It's probably close now.
Can we assist you? Luck be with you.
Haste for another 6 hours. Should be good. Well, it's not as bad as I thought it would be. I figured there were far more of them in here. Of course, it still hurts a lot, because they're, well, powerful. But I believe the purple ones are medium, yeah. The red ones are the strongest, and there's pretty much only blue and purple ones here. So guess I'm lucky on that count too. Which means I can probably clear this in one go. The normal defenders of VARN are very weak. Only 220 hit points. Share life. Okay, I should stick to close combat and turn based. Unless they're all dead in melee. Let them come to me instead of me going to them. Mm. Are they far away? Dragon breath or not? Take my chances. Yeah, they're all far enough. I remember me having to teleport back to town every time my magic ran out, but what I would do before I found out magic is actually quite weak in comparison to melee. Before I always used four sorcerers or something, and now I found out melee is actually quite potent as well. So before I found that out, I usually ran in here, threw in a few scrap metals, and teleported out to replenish my spell points. But now I just melee and hope for a nice pack to collect, so I can throw a fireball or dragon breath in there to speed up the process. But oh, the guardians are immune to poison. But now I can just melee and heal up whenever needed. So I suppose a challenge run with a knight and paladin and two more knights is doable, although still pretty hard with only one healer and no magic damage. But it might just work. However, I would probably not record all of that because, well, this one took 80 parts so far, and with no ways of teleporting and other ways of traveling, it'd probably take like 4 times as much. If you jump on this water paths things, you'll activate a question, and if you answer that one, the navigator is Sulu and backwards is Ulus. You lose the scroll, I think. I don't know. Do I? Think I do. And that makes you one step closer to opening the next section. Communication offices. And then this one is the engineer Scotty. Still the occasional radiation damage. Suppose the radiation is from the control cube. And I don't think I activated this one yet, but I don't seem to be able to. Oh, there we go. First mate, that was Spark Subs. Incorrect. Fuck you. Spark. There we go. And this should be the last one. A Dr. McCoy. Yuckum. That wasn't the last one, was it? It was. Then the Well of VARN must be keyed last. Oh. This one? No, that's just a jump down. That is that thing, I think. And which should be the captain's code. Let's crick. And then we can jump down, taking us to where I thought it would take us. And in here, yeah, robots. And these things are not to be underestimated. These things have an instant eradicate attack, which can completely fuck you over if you're unlucky. I don't think the weaker ones do it, only the Terminator units. It looks like I won't have a chance to find out. This should contain control cube. What we're here for. And the spear might take long if I can hold it. Can't. Okay, so we're done with this dungeon. I did not expect to be done already. But I suppose it's for the best because this place is a pain in the ass. Let's take the cube to the Oracle. This way. I suppose we can train again, you know. 69, 5 levels, almost 5 levels from the dungeon. So, a few more points in light and dark. It's not gonna matter at this point. Enter the Oracle. System on. Check the haste time. 4 hours. Good. Hello, Mr. Oracle. I brought you your control key. You now have access to the control center. Simply ask to be transported and I will bleach. One warning, arrived, the guardians of the control center no longer under my control, so please exercise caution while visiting the center. Kriegan. As I said, the Kriegan are resistant to most of the weapons available in Anorath, but not all. To rid the world of them, you will need to find where the vessel crashed and destroy the main reactor. The only problem is that the resulting explosion from the reactor will destroy this planet. You will need a powerful spell to prevent the explosion from damaging the planet, but not only like that exists. But no spell like that exists in the world today. The only person I can think of that would know of such a spell is Archibald, but he is in no condition to teach you. To make matters worse, the reactor cannot be harmed by normal weapons or spells. You will need the ancient weapons in the control center to destroy the reactor. And though my memory has been damaged by Archibald, I can still remember the danger that our ancient enemy, the Kriegan, posed to our world. The Kriegan first appeared roughly 1500 years ago, attacking outlying colonies and stealing their resources. It was thought that at the time they simply needed certain minerals and could be reasoned with, but this was not the case. Their life cycle forces them to breed until the world cannot support their numbers. Then they send ships off to other worlds to renew the cycle. Their attacks against the Empire of Ancients disrupted the network of shipping and communications that held us together, causing the silence that marked the first year of our modern calendar. Without support from the homeworlds, our fledgling technology failed, bringing us to the sorry state. I would help rebuild our technology, but it seems to have become a religious figure in the minds of many people, and very few visit me or understand what I have to offer. Perhaps this Kriegan crisis we face will bring people to their senses as long as we survive it. So our next quest is to obtain arcane magic from Archibald in Royal Castle and go to the control center, which we will be doing in the next episode.